Hello, my dear students. How are you, all of you? I think you are very good. Stay in home. Don't come outside. So today we start the third part of this chapter 1, Matter in Our Surrounding. So heartily welcome to online class. My dear students, Sharadu. ಶರಣಾರ್ಥಿಗಳು ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ನೈಂತ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ ಕೆಮಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿ ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಚಾಪ್ಟರ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮ್ಯಾಟರ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಸರೌಂಡಿಂಗ್ ಸೊ ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ವಿ ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ದ ರಿಮೈನಿಂಗ್ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಆಸ್ಪೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ಆರ್ ದೋಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಓಕೆ ಆರ್ ಯು ರೆಡಿ ಟು ಲಿಸನಿಂಗ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್ ಓಕೆ ಫೈನ್ ಓಕೆ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಲಾಸ್ಟ್ period we have discussed that states of matter those are three different states they are solids liquids and gaseous state along with these matters we have stated that properties of solids properties of liquids properties of gases so today we will discuss the new aspect in this class that is change of state which point we will discuss here change of state so here we have observed that three states of matter those are the solids liquids and gases so these states how they can be changes so let's we discuss when a solid is heated it changes into liquid when a liquid is heated it changes into gas For example, we'll discuss later. See here, when the solid things are there, or solid matters are there, these solid matters will changes into liquid when you have heated. So similarly, you know that when a liquid is heated, it changes into gas. Okay, then we can see. One example here if ice is heated it changes into water if water is heated it changes into steam if steam is cooled it changes into water if water is cooled it changes into ice so this is a very good example and only this ice is having three states of matter so if the ice is in solid then it can be changes into liquid by heating so next this water is heated continuously it changes into steam again this steam is cooled slowly it changes into water if water is cooled it and changes into ice so this is the good example of changes of state when a gas is cooled it changes to liquid when a liquid is cooled changes into solid okay so here the flow chart is there one flow chart so that is solid state is changes into liquid state liquid state is changes into gaseous state how the solid state it changes into liquid state by heating arrow mark is one direction okay then liquid state is changes into gaseous state how by heat and like that here also that gas you collected and cool slowly it again change into liquid and this liquid again cool then it changes into solid in state so this is the flow chart which shows the change of states like solid to liquid liquid to gaseous state and along with here one activity is there so in a beaker we have taken ice cubes the particles are close together and cannot move about okay in the beaker so below the beaker you start slowly heating process so it can be melt after melting it changes into liquid in state Okay, are you observing in the second beaker? Yeah. So it form ice is changes into water. Water is nothing but liquid in state. So you can observe here the particles move faster and further apart. And again continuously heating this water, it changes into steam or boiling water. So the particles are far apart and move very quickly and randomly. So the steam is having their particles randomly movement and in all direction. So this is the good example and a good activity of changes of state in water. Okay, next we will see second slide. Melting is there, which one? Melting. So when a solid is heated, this melting is also known as fusion. When a solid is heated, the particles begin to vibrate with greater speed and begin to move more freely. So when the solid ice cube is heated, the particles starts their vibration with greater speed and begin to move more freely. Then at a particular temperature, the solid melts and changes into liquid. So if the ice cube or solid can get into particular temperature, by this particular temperature, the solid ice can be slowly melts and changes into liquid. Are you understanding? Yes. The process of melting is also known as fusion. Melting is also known as fusion. Why it can be melt? The temperature at which a solid melts is called its melting point. So how much temperature need to solid ice cube to melts into liquid state? So this change of the state of the point is called melting point. The melting point of ice is 0 degrees Celsius, or it is 273 Kelvin. So clear? So how much degree Celsius need to melt of ice cube here? 0 degrees Celsius or 273 Kelvin. Now in this melting or fusion, another new aspect is there, that is latent heat of fusion. What is the latent heat of fusion? The amount of heat energy required to change 1 kg of a solid into liquid at atmospheric pressure at its melting point is called the latent heat of the fusion. You observe here 1 kg of solid ice cubes are there. This ice cubes are changes into liquid in state. So how much heat energy required to change, and also at atmospheric pressure. So this melting point is called latent heat of fusion. So once again I will repeat the definition. The amount of heat energy required to change 1 kg of a solid into liquid, it changed at atmospheric pressure at its melting point is called the latent heat of fusion. So now you can observe the how it can be changes. Yes, changing. Here in the beaker we have taken ice cube and observe the temperature with the help of thermometer, and when it starts the melting, it takes that 0 degree Celsius or 273 degree Celsius. So this change of solid ice into liquid and how much amount of heat energy required to change of solid into liquid at atmospheric pressure of melting point is called latent heat of fusion. Is it clear? Yes. Okay. Next, we are discussing boiling. When a liquid is heated, it is very familiar. When a liquid is heated, its particles begin to move even faster. How they are getting heat? The liquid particles. So it converted into steam, that particles to move even faster. Then at a particular temperature, the liquid begins to boil and changes into gas or vapor. What do you call here? Gas or vapor. So the water is there, you are continuously heating. So the particles of the water is converted into steam or gas or vapor. So that time these particles are moving very faster. So this is known as what you call boiling. So boiling is a bulk phenomenon. It is a big phenomenon. When a liquid boils, the bulk of the liquid changes into vapor. So it changes into vapor. The liquid boils, the bulk of the liquid changes into vapor. This process is also known as boiling. The temperature at which a liquid starts boiling is called its boiling point. How much temperature required to change liquid to it changes into vapor. So that point is called boiling point. So it is also shortly we can call in chemistry BP, not a blood pressure. Here BP means boiling point. The boiling point of water is 100 degrees Celsius or 373 Kelvin. So when you can add 273 plus 100 is equal to 373 Kelvin. So it is the SI unit of boiling point. In the international level, 373 Kelvin, and commonly we are saying 100 degree Celsius of the boiling of water. Next, just we have finished that latent heat of which point here? Latent heat of fusion we have completed. Now we are discussing here the latent heat of vaporization. Vaporization means converting into vapor by the boiling of water. So the definition of latent heat of vaporization, what is that? The amount of heat energy required to change 1 kg of a liquid into gas at atmospheric pressure at its boiling point is called latent heat of vaporization. So here the definition of latent heat of the vaporization. So here in the beaker we have taken liquid. How much? 1 kg or 1 liter. So this liquid changes into gaseous state. So how much amount of heat is required? So you can give that much of the heat. So at atmospheric pressure at its boiling point is called latent heat of vaporization. So we can compare the latent heat of the we have studied that fusion and latent heat of the vaporization. Now I will comparison between the latent heat of fusion and the latent heat of the vaporization. So latent heat of the fusion means the amount of heat energy required to change 1 kg of a solid into liquid at atmospheric pressure at its melting point is called the latent heat of the fusion. So here what is the latent heat of the vaporization? The amount of heat energy required to change 1 kg of liquid into gas at atmospheric pressure at its boiling point is called the latent heat of vaporization. So the boiling point of water or fusion is 0 degree Celsius, and here the melting point of water is 0 degree Celsius, and next boiling point of water is 100 degree Celsius, and next we are saying in the Kelvin. So melting point or fusion of the ice cube 273 Kelvin, next boiling point of water is 373 Kelvin. So we have compared these two points. So let's restart another point. Just you observe, we have taken water in a beaker and dipped that thermometer and heat slowly. So here the water or liquid changes into gas, because the amount of heat is required to change of this one. And along with the atmospheric pressure, its boiling point is called latent heat of vaporization. Okay, understood? Now you observe effects of temperature on molecular motion. In the cold, all solid particles are very closely packed. When you give heat or right amount of the heat to this solid, the particles are just apart. Okay, in the liquid, so in the cold temperature, all are together particles and a little gap.
Thank you, my dear students. Sharanu Sharanarthigalu.